Good afternoon and welcome to Spielberg, and to a circuit that in one form or another has held every Austrian Grand Prix in the championship, except the very first back in 1964. It was at this race that John Watson lost a bet, and his beard, when he took Team Penske's only F1 victory in 1976. If anything, the stakes are even higher today, with 25 points available for victory and a crucial advantage in the championship fight. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 metres above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn 1 or the tight uphill turn 3. Anthony Davidson joins me again for the race today. Let's talk about McLaren. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Kimi Raikkonen's perfect lap yesterday sees him start from pole position, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Ricciardo, Valtteri Bottas, and Verstappen, Grosjean, Sainz, Alonso, and Stoffel van Dorn, Magnussen, Ocon, Sergio Perez, and Hülkenberg, De Vries, Ericsson, Charles Leclerc, and Lance Stroll, Gasly, and Sergei Sirotkin rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation. Start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. race.
Thank you.
place.
Plus one. Fast.
best in luck you can.
Seconds.
Okay, car ahead is now running the super soft tyre. That's the super soft on the car ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 5.7 seconds. Our gap behind is 4.6 seconds. Is 14.9 seconds. The gap to the car behind is 6.8 seconds.
Thank you.
CRS deployment. Is 9.1 seconds. We're not going to be able to run in this engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Seconds.
Seconds.
today. I think the boss will be happy with that one.
So, another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. So then, championship. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I have to give to De Vries. They did a great job at getting the most out of their tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern-day Formula One.
On to the constructors then. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling instalment of this Formula One season.
Great workout there today. How do you think it went? You're breaking all expectations. What's your secret? You really cut your way through the field today. What was your strategy? Did you have the wrong fuel strategy today, or was it your management? Appreciate your time.